Given the current state of the world, Apple and Google are doing something they have never done. Join forces against the common enemy. While this seems like a match made in heaven, there are some serious concerns regarding this partnership. In this video, we will be talking about it and tell you everything you need to know. So sit back, relax, and let me tech. Tech companies around the world are fighting back against coronavirus, aka COVID-19. New phones at unbelievable prices are being launched. Paid content is being made available for free. Huge donations are being made, and even factories are being modified to produce masks and other equipment needed for the fight back. The biggest news of all was Apple and Google announcing a tracking system. Both companies plan to provide an API to public health authorities, followed by building this functionality into underlying platform, i.e. both iOS and Android. The first version of this API was expected in May, but yesterday Tim Cook announced that the API will be available ahead of schedule on 28th April. This shows how committed both companies are to this project. Let us explain how this API works, or at least how it is supposed to work. The technology that is making it possible is Bluetooth. Your Bluetooth device, which in case will be your iPhone or Android-powered smartphone, will be sending and receiving short codes, which technically is known as low-energy beacon system. Your smartphone will be keeping a log of all the codes you have been in close proximity with. And if someone whom you have been close to is diagnosed with COVID-19, you will get a notification on your device. The notification will tell you that you might have been infected and you should self-isolate. In case of serious condition, you need to contact proper authorities. With over 3 billion devices globally, this could really be helpful in avoiding the spread of COVID-19 and better control it. While basic privacy measures such as encryption, keeping the codes on your device locally and not sharing them anywhere, and also changing the codes regularly so you cannot track the actual device, there are still a lot of questions being raised. World-renowned whistleblower Edward Snowden has also publicly mentioned his concerns. He shared an article on Twitter which mentions that while no location data is being collected and everything stays on the phone, proximity records can be highly revealing. These records can expose who you spend most time with. If you are a user of Facebook, it should not be an issue at all, as this person already knows how much time you spend with others and probably a lot more. The second major concern is regarding the accuracy of this tool. How would you define that you were in close proximity of an infected person? There are a lot of factors that need to be considered for this. Will it be reliable enough? These are very, very important questions, because if it is not accurate and reliable, it could lead to a lot of false alarms. That could lead to panic and way more problems. We will have to see in the upcoming days if these issues are addressed. And will it benefit the fight back against COVID-19? One very alarming statement by Snowden is that if it is not properly controlled and monitored, this could be the next big tool for mass surveillance. In a statement today, Apple and Google both have pledged that they will shut it down once the pandemic is over. What do you guys think? Do you think it will be the next big thing for mass surveillance? Let us know in the comments below. Apart from the API collaboration with Google, we previously reported that Apple has prioritized food delivery, hospital and pharmacies in Apple Map when you click search. Apple has now also added COVID-19 testing sites in Apple Map natively. This is another one of several steps taken by Apple. Apple has also added COVID-19 screening on their website along with the standalone app. We will leave the links for these in the description below. Apple has also launched a company-wide effort to design, produce and ship face shields to medical workers. Tim Cook announced this via a video message on Twitter. Tim says that Apple plans to ship 1 million face shields weekly. These face shields are fully adjustable and easy to assemble. Apple has an entire support page dedicated to this face shield along with a demo video on how to assemble. You can find its link in the description as well. Apple is also trying hard to avoid the spread of misinformation. Apple recently purchased the domain applecoronavirus.com. There are no details as of yet what Apple plans to do with it. Will Apple make a standalone app? Or will Apple link it or redirect it to current screening or support page on official Apple website? The most obvious goal as of now is that Apple did not want someone else to register it and then use it to spread misinformation. Will Apple do something else with this domain? We will know in the next few weeks. Last but certainly not least, Apple unveils Maps tools showing activity changes during ongoing pandemic. What it does is basically takes data from Apple Maps anonymously and shows the volume of people driving, walking, or taking public transport. This is another attempt by Apple to help the local authorities and local government to better understand the patterns and help control the spread of coronavirus. Apple recently also released a very heart-touching video on YouTube titled Creativity Goes On. It shows that even while at home, you can continue to inspire the world and do wonders. You, of course, need Apple products to do that. All jokes aside, it is really good to see that tech companies led by Apple are putting a lot of effort to make sure everyone stays home, stays connected, and keep on doing their job from safety of their homes. In the end, we will like to wish Ramadan to everyone. Ramadan Mubarak. We pray that we may win our battle against COVID-19 soon. Over and out.